We get into our newsroom about vandalism at now what is more than a dozen churches in Jefferson County. All of this in the past 24 hours. And it is not just religious buildings.
That's right. At least one home and the YMCA in Roebuck were also hit. Fox 6 News reporter Vanessa Ariza has been following this developing story for us. Vanessa.
Well, Beth, Jonathan, whoever is doing this is writing the word minutia or something that looks similar to that on these buildings. And most of those buildings, like you said, have been churches on their doors and right in front of them.
We use all of these, but probably 90% of people go through those doors.
Senior pastor of Solid Rock Church in Pinson, Larry Raglin, is still trying to figure out why someone would spray paint this word on the front door of his church.
Well, the first thing it makes me think is I'm very sad for the condition of the world we're in right now.
His church isn't the only location hit. Add to that at least a dozen other worship centers, all of different denominations, Roebuck's YMCA, and even a home. Besides the act itself, what everyone is trying to figure out is the meaning, if any, behind this word.
Immediately, we're trying to interpret what it means, sounding it out.
Authorities believe most of the vandalism was done during the night, but surveillance video from Roebuck's YMCA timed one suspect at 4:35 Thursday afternoon.
The front seemed to be clear, and he simply walked up, put something on the sidewalk, and as quickly as he came, he left.
Executive Director of Roebuck's YMCA, Terry Harville, says the video shows a man wearing a baseball cap, covering up most of his face. She says no one was in danger and police were quick to respond.
They were actually here, taking down our information, and they were already getting a call about the next situation.
Jeb Leslie's daughter noticed the similar markings on their church Friday afternoon.
When I called the police, they immediately asked me, are you a Good Samaritan church on Huffman Road? I said, no, ma'am. Has another church been hit? It makes me sad, really, because it shows a hatred for churches and for Christianity in general.
I talked to the sergeant at Jefferson County Sheriff's Office. He tells me that two people have been taken into the sheriff's office for questioning. That was around 4:30 this afternoon. I just spoke with him. He says that they are still there for being questioned. He also tells me that more patrols are going to be around those areas that have been hit. Live in the newsroom tonight, Vanessa Ariza, Fox 6 News, on your side.
Vanessa, thanks. We have a breaking news update for you. I-65 North now back open in Shelby County after a fatal accident. A viewer tweeted us this picture showing the SUV here on top of another car. Looks like a Camry there near exit 234. That's the Shelby County Airport's area. State police tell us one person here has died. Now, this accident happened about 7 o'clock tonight. Our live Fox 6 traffic tracker still showing slow traffic in that area almost half an hour after the interstate reopened. So if you're traveling I-65 North tonight, expect some delays at least for another hour or two.
New at 10, we're learning more about the Alabama connections of a Georgia father charged with